Hallo, hallo, Mic Test. You can also get the live option chain data of any particular instrument as well. So for example, for Bank Nifty, participant wise open interest, as I mentioned, open interest is very or highly tracked by traders. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. This is the second video of our playlist on NSE Lib Python package that we are exploring. This Python package is used to extract NSE stock and futures and options data in Python. And yes, this Python package is made on the new website of NSE. A lot of people are facing a lot of problem on data extraction from NSE, from National Stock Exchange or NSE website, because they have changed the website. Most of the past Python packages are not working now, but yes, I'm back. This is the new Python package that you guys can use. So yes, guys, if you're new to my YouTube channel, on this channel, I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, using some highly valuable finance APIs, making some trading strategies on platforms like Pinescript, etc., etc. So if you're interested in something like this, then you should click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are many more videos and playlists that are coming on this YouTube channel for free. And yes, my goal is to make you a successful financial programmer. In the last video, I talked about extraction of stock related data using the NSE Lib Python library. This is the code that we made in the last video. The link of the video is in the description section. If you would like to see, you can check it out. This is the documentation of NSE Lib. Again, thanks to Ruchi Tanmay, who has actually made this thing to life. In the last video, as I mentioned, we have talked about the capital markets data. In this video, we'll be talking about the derivatives data. This is the GitHub page for the package, and as I mentioned, yeah, we will be talking about the derivatives data. The links of both this URL is in the description section. You can just minimize this video and click on that link in the description section. In the last video, we talked about things like price, volume, and deliverable position data, which is basically the stock specific historical data on the pricing information, volume, and deliverable information like the turnover or traded volume, etc., all those things. Then we have the price volume data as well, deliverable position data. The data frame that we got as an output from these three functions were very much similar. So yeah, as I mentioned in the last video, we would actually collate it in most of the cases in the real world and then use it for our further analysis. Things like bulk deal data, block deal data, short selling data, very important. Then we have bhav copy with delivery, bhav copy equities, equity list, FNO equity list, and other functions as well. In this video, I will be talking about these functions. So I will start writing my code from this, in this particular Google Colab only. I will keep this code in my Google Drive. Please watch this video till the end to see how to get an access of my Google Drive. And there are many more study materials and my personal projects which are saved in that Google Drive. Just stay tuned till the end and then you'll get to know about it. So firstly, I will use from nslib import derivatives. In order to install nslib Python package, you just use the pip functionality, which is pip install nslib, which we have already done in the last video. So yeah, from nslib import derivatives. Now let's see what all different functions are useful in the derivative module. So the first date is expiry date future, right? We know that the last Thursday is an expiry date for a lot of derivatives traded in India. So the last Thursday of December is 28th December, then 25th December is the last Thursday of January, the last Thursday of February is the last day of the month itself, which is 29th of February 2024. 2024 is a leap year, so that's why we have 29th. Now this was for for futures. What is the function for options? Here we go, which is expiry dates option index. So for different indices, there are multiple expiry dates available. And you can see that Nifty, we have 28th, then 4th, then 11th, and so on. It's actually every Thursday, which is an expiry for Nifty. Then Fin Nifty and Bank Nifty is also available here. Again, you can refer to these expiry dates using this function called expiry dates option index. Now, if you're interested to extract the FII trading information in the FNO market, by saying FII, I mean foreign institutional investors. DII is domestic institutional investor. So in order to extract the FII information, you'll just write FII underscore derivatives underscore statistics. And then you need to provide a date here. So let's do 22nd of December 2023. When we run this, you'll see all the different indices, options and futures, which are on the left hand side, right, which is FII derivatives. By contract, these are the number of contracts, right, which were bought. By value in crore, right, you can see it here. Sell contracts, sell value in crore. Open contracts value in crore, right. So all this information is only specific to the FIAs. Now, as we have a bhav copy of stock, right, or of equity, we have a bhav copy of FNO as well, right. So you just need to write derivatives.fno underscore bhav underscore copy and then the date inside. You'll see all the different types of the future index, option index or future stocks or option stocks information, right? Here you can see there are close to 62,000 rows here. All important information such as strike price, right? Option type, which is basically PE is put European, CE is call European and so on. Open high, low, close. Right, settle PR, contract, valuation in lakh, or I think value in lakh, open interest, change in open interest, and timestamp. All this information, which is basically a bhav copy of FNO. If you're interested to extract any stock future historical data, right, so we'll be using this function called derivatives.future price volume data, right, in the last 1 month. So in here, we need to provide the ticker name, which is in this case, if you're using the stock ticker name, it is SBIN here, or for Infosys say Infi. Now, because it's a stock, we will write FUTSTK, which is future stock, and then period is 1 month. If it's an index, then we will write IDX, FUTIDX. I'll do it in the next cell. So let's just run this first. So you'll get last 1 month of future stock for SBI in front of you, right? Again, all relevant information, which is open interest, change in open interest, total traded volume, total quantity, settle price, and then open high low close is there as well, and so on. Now, as I mentioned, you can just do it for index as well. So let me just copy and paste it here. Let me just write Bank Nifty, and here it's FUTIDX, and let's run it. So we'll get all the information of Bank Nifty of last 1 month. Again, all these things are available, such as open interest, open high, low, close, etc. You can also get the live option chain data of any particular instrument as well. So for example, for Bank Nifty, if you want an option chain data for the expiry date of 28th of December 2023, you just use the function called derivatives.nec underscore live underscore option underscore chain and provide the symbol, which is Bank Nifty in our case, and the expiry date. You'll see the entire option chain in front of us, basically all different types of call, right? And here on the right hand side, there are puts, as I think you might already know that option chain is basically a set of different types of calls and puts that is tracked by a lot of traders for both options and intraday traders, because it gives a very good idea about the direction of the market, right? Again, the change in the OI, which is open interest, the put OI and the call AI is something that people track a lot, I think. So you can definitely consider this for analysis. So I'll just go ahead with the next one. Extracting the options data, right? So option underscore price underscore volume underscore data, which is price volume data for option. Again, we'll just provide the symbol name, which is Bank Nifty in our case. And because it's an option index, we will write OPTIDX. If it is option stock, we'll write OPTST. TK, right? So yeah, it's very similar to the one the last function that we used for stock as well. Just run this cell and you'll see the entire price volume data for Bank Nifty for last 1 month. So it starts from 22nd of December, 23rd of November, and you'll see all this data in front of you. Last, a couple of things.
Just before that, guys, I have a very important information to share. Recently, I launched a course on Python for financial programming. So if you are trying to learn Python for finance from scratch, then this is something that you might be interested in. Just go to my website, which is fpritvik.com/python. Over here, you will see two buttons, Indian candidates, non-Indian candidates. So you can click as per your location. It will redirect you to this, the main website where the entire course information is available. You'll see that there are 5 sessions, 10 chapters, 22 videos, 10 quizzes and 3 assignments with 2 live projects. And this is the entire syllabus of this course for all the people who are interested to learn Python from scratch and who are struggling learning Python on their own. I highly recommend it because it's very, very affordable and I have covered a lot of things from a very, very simplistic eyesight. And in the end, in session 4 and 5, you'll see stock analysis and investment portfolio creation projects, which are my personal projects. We did it using some financial analysis. If you use RTK40 code, you'll get an instant 40% discount, which is only available for the first 100 candidates. So yes, guys, I'll see you in the course. Let's come back to our code.
Last, a couple of things. Participant-wise open interest. As I mentioned, open interest is very, very or highly tracked by traders, right? So they have mentioned this separately as well, which is participant-wise open interest. For on 22nd of December 2023, different types of clients, right? Client DIA, which is domestic institutional investors, FII, which is foreign institutional investors, and Pro, I think it's professional traders, right? And different types of things like future index long, future index short, future stock long, future stock short, option index call long, option index put long, and so on. So all this information is available, which is basically the open interest for different types of segments, right? Now, if you'd like to see the volume rather than open interest for like based on the participant type, right? It's you can just use participant wise trading volume and then provide the date inside it. You'll see the client DIA, FIA, Pro again on the left hand side, but here the numbers are basically the volume for different types of securities, right? So yes, guys, that's it for this video. I don't want to make this more complicated. I think we have covered enough material for our third video, which is making a financial dashboard. For the financial dashboard, I will be referring to the first two videos. The last video was on the stocks data extraction. This video is on the derivatives or FNO data extraction. I'll be using the functions from these two videos. So yes, please watch these two videos before watching the third video. And as I mentioned in the beginning, this code will be saved in my Google Drive. And there are many more codes which are saved in my Google Drive and a lot of study materials that I made for myself. My personal codes such as my trading bots, my personal educational PineScript trading strategies, etc. Are over there. So in order to become a Google Drive community member, just search Financial Programming with Ritvik on YouTube and click on my channel. And over here, just click on this particular link, which is on the right side of the logo, which is my photo. Just click on this link and you'll see the step-by-step procedure of how to become a Google Drive community member. You'll see that the cost of my Google Drive community is very, very small. And the reason I'm charging this small amount of money because I had a couple of interns who are helping me provide the best possible content on Google Drive. So yeah, this is how you'll be supporting my YouTube channel as well. If you liked even just one thing about this video, guys, just click on that like button. It's free of cost for you, but it helps really with the algorithm on YouTube. And also click on the subscribe button. Again, it's free for you, but I am 100% sure that this particular click will help you a lot in future because there is a lot of quality content that will be coming on this YouTube channel in future as well. Many more quality playlists that will be coming here very soon. Also, let me know in the comment section if you want any particular topic for me to cover for the future videos. The next video is on financial dashboard. And if you would like to involve me or my team in your personal projects, then yes, guys, we do provide freelancing services as well. In fact, I have a team of 11 experienced professionals now who help me deliver the best possible services to my clients across the world. So just write an email on this particular email address and someone from my team will reach out to you as soon as possible. Last but not the least, the link of my course is in the description section. I highly recommend it for someone who is new to Python and who would like to learn Python from scratch and would like to explore some really important topics such as stock analysis and investment portfolio creation, etc. The link of the course is in the description section. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And over there, you'll see this entire playlist on NSA Lib. There's the second video. So yes, the third video is coming very soon, next Saturday. Over there, you'll see my MT5 trading bot that I created a few weeks ago. And you guys have given me a very good response on that video. Keep learning, keep financial programming. I'll see you in the next video next Saturday. Till then, peace.